Okay. So, I've got some repairs to do, and I'm gonna go ahead and try to live stream this and see if it is fun for you guys or not. It could be absolutely boring, or you might enjoy it if you got nothing better to do. So, I won't be able to talk a whole lot because I'm gonna have the camera on this guy. Like it? I think it'll work. What's up, guys? So, my plan is hopefully this is a GoPro head mount, and I got a cheap cell phone attachment, and I just hooked them together the other day. So, I'm gonna put my phone in there and see if you guys can see what's going on. Guys on YouTube stole some of our videos. Ugh, I know that happens a lot. That's okay. If you guys send me a link to those videos that are stolen or ripped, I can report it through YouTube. And usually, YouTube's pretty good about taking them down pretty quick. So, yeah, thanks for standing up for me. So, anyways. Yeah, I'll give you a quick update. We're basically the weekend we didn't do much cutting. We finished all the winter wheat. Spring wheat is almost ready. We have some big repairs we're doing to the combines. So I'm in the shop today, and it's like 90 some degrees outside, so it's kind of nice to be in here. It's a little colder. I'll switch to the camera here so you can see the combines are in there, parked outside here, getting all the work done to them. And I decided it was time to fix up these spreaders. They have about 1,300 hours on them or so, and you can see the ends are—they're not wore out, but they're wore enough. And these plates—I'll take this off here—are cracking through. You can see the cracks better if I flip it up like this. See right there. So, where I believe why it's cracking there is this is where the spreaders were originally mounted. And as the straw is hitting here, you can see the shiny polished. As the straw hits, I think it catches this edge of the spreader right there and slowly wears a line in here. So, my plan is to rebuild every one of these and then use some real light flat iron and put a splice in just between these bolt holes that are already here and bolt them in tight. And that way, there's a flat iron I'm gonna need. So, I got this old pipe right here. You can already see it, I've marked it a couple times. And I'm cutting off some moon-shaped slices here. And my plan is just to lightly weld them, every one on the back side of these spreaders, just to get a little more wear, rather than going and buying new pieces for outrageously amounts of money. We can hopefully get a little more life out of these. And I've got four of these to do. You can see my other ones are stacked right here. So, but I won't be able to respond much to you guys' comments because I'm gonna be working. So you can keep watching or tune out or whatever you want to do. But hey, something new, right? Okay. So I'm gonna put this up here. Let's click this phone in. And there we go. All right. Nice. I wish I had a wide angle lens on this camera. That'd work a lot better. Okay, so I can't really tell. Let me hide the comments. Can I do that? One second. Let me turn the comments off so I can't see them because they're blocking them. I can barely see the screen. Okay, all right. Yeah, I think you guys can see pretty well. Okay, all right. Let's do this. So, first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna chop this up. We're gonna make a bunch of pieces. I think I need 12 of these because there's three per spreader and four spreaders. So I'll take this over the chop saw. You can see we got stuff everywhere. During harvest, we kind of make a mess. Cleanup isn't really on the priority list. It's sort of just get the job done while you can. So we'll chop a few of these off right now. Thank you.
nice and hot. So I take these, and we'll dunk them one by one in the water here. Let it cool down. Doesn't take much, just a couple seconds in the water and it sucks the heat right out of them. Okay. All right, good. Okay, making progress here. So, Sharpies don't like to write on wet surfaces very well, but I'll take, since I already plasmid these out, so it's kind of my blueprint here. So I'll just take my Sharpie here and just draw a line right where I want to cut it. Okay. And we can get two out of every one of these. So let's do another side right there. Like that. Okay, and that's the side we don't want. All right, so this right here is your plasma cutter. These things are great. It actually creates a plasma stream. I don't know all the science behind it, but it's similar to a welder. You have to have your ground attached. So what I'll do, so I'll clip this on right here where I don't want them, and I'm gonna go get my shades on because this stuff isn't real great to stare at. Let me put this on. Okay. There we go. All right. So it's really simple. It's like a torch. Just doesn't use oxygen or acetylene. It uses electricity and compressed air, which is my airline right there. Just take it. We'll start a new one. Mark these up. Okay. This doesn't have to be precision. This part's going to get wore out anyways and not long, so as long as it's relatively close to the size I want it to be, then it'll work. I don't know if I can hardly see those lines. Okay, here we go. Okay. Did I do that right? Yeah, I did. Hang on a second here. Yeah, that's correct. My lines are in different spots. That one, okay. There we go, there's some more. And the sparks aren't real bad. They kind of burn when they hit your skin, but they're really not. They're so fine particles that the heat dissipates really quickly, so it doesn't really bother you. I wouldn't want to get it in my eyes, but they're not that dangerous, so that's why you can see I don't mind sparks spraying all over me. Mark these. You can hear there's other stuff going on in the shop over there. My brother's hard at work on another project. We'll probably go inspect and see what he's doing here in a little bit. See if he needs fired or not. Because sometimes, you know, he just doesn't work hard enough, so we have to keep an eye on him. Okay. Keep doing this. One left. Get all that water off that. Okay. Let's see here. Line across there. There. These spreaders probably could have lasted the season, but rather than having them break on us and then fixing them, because at that point when they break, a lot of times you're in the crunch and then you just decide to go buy new because you don't want to deal with trying to fix it. So since we have a day where we can do this kind of stuff, I'm going to do it now. Did I mark this right? Let's see. That's one there. That line right there. I don't know what that is. Two there. One, two. Okay. So this is the spreader. Okay. All right. Yeah, that's correct. Okay. Drew extra lines on this. Okay. All right. So we got, and they're actually not too bad. It cuts them so fast that, and this is such thin metal, the heat doesn't really stick in it very long. So they're usually able to touch them. Edges are kind of sharp though. So we have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight, and I need 12 of them. Got a couple more of these rings. Five, six. All right, let's use this one as a blueprint here. Okay. I think this is a drive this can't be a drive shaft. That's too thin. It might be. I don't know what this pipe came from. So that's one, two, three, four. Perfect. Okay, let's cut those off. Babies get hot. All right. I have an air hose here. Let me blow these off so I can draw on them. Perfect. Oh, that's kind of weird. Let's not do that one. That'll work. Right there. That's a good one, right? Okay. Speeds things up a little bit. Okay. All right, let's mark these. My awesome straight lines. It over. Okay. enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. All right. Now, I want to weld them to these. Get in there. Let's see, where's my ground at? It's already under here. Okay, ground's right there. So my plan is to put them not on the inside, but on the outside. And just the hole right here. I can't tell if that's correct. Yeah, that should work. Okay. Yeah, that's looking. Okay. See, I just took off my my little thing here. I'm not even paying attention to you guys' comments. Apologize. Yeah. All right. And if I'm correct, I think welding's not good for cameras. So I'm going to put the camera a little further away while I weld on these. So, yeah, hang tight. Do whatever you want to do. Let's find a place to put this camera. While I weld on this. Put it right there. You see that okay? Get that away there. Okay. All right. Nice. Perfect. Okay. Well, I can show you this real quick. You guys probably know a thing or two about welding, but not that we're pros, but basically you've got argon gas compressed in this big container. And then your welder, this is an old welder, but it works really good. And the argon gas displaces the oxygen so that the weld doesn't bubble. The oxygen messes up the weld, and so the argon gas comes out of the welding tip and gives you a nice quality weld. Okay, I'll try to whip through these. This could be a long video. Won't take a lot of weld. I just did about an inch beads both sides. This thing doesn't need a lot to hold it on, just so it doesn't go flying off, but that's all it should take. There's one that's not fixed yet, you can see. I'm putting those guys on there. There. Let's watch this real quick.
Scott's,
Hey, how you guys doing?
He's fixing that transmission, shaft that stripped the inside of the splines out that stopped us the other day. So he's pressing the bearing on the shaft here. Did all the parts were they correct?
Yep. Looks okay. Like it's,
what did that total?
See, the shaft is over 700. It was like, oh, you'd have to look at the sheet for.
I'm curious how much that bearing was.
So I put the shaft in the freezer a little bit. Just
where did you?
Cool it down some. Make sure I get that fairly. Make sure that bearing's facing the correct way.
You already put that collar on the other side?
Nope.
Okay.
Not yet.
Alright. Okay. Cool.
Should raise this up a little bit.
Oh, you want to go to that one? Collar. That's gotta get pressed inside there.
You gotta make sure you have it the correct direction, otherwise.
Is there two sides to it?
Well, because it's tapered.
Oh, it is tapered. Oh, yeah.
You have to make sure that the release is correct. If you don't make sure, well, then we'll sing a different tune later.
Yeah, this is a Grizzly. Grizzly press. Got our foot pounds? PSI. Yeah.
Just make sure. Like making a mistake today. How about that?
Yeah, it's kind of an important part.
Now it might need to be pressed a little deeper. Go grab the other one, just
see how it is. So probably about a grand for this thing right here. After everything's said and done, I bet it's about $1,000. But without this, you're going nowhere. Fortunately, this is all that happened. It could have been a lot worse. It's pretty close. They have it flush with it. Yeah.
Yeah, it's sitting flush.
Those gears look any different in the wear? Probably not.
No,
about the same.
Not really, but the inside looks a little different.
Yeah.
There's
one's got splines, one doesn't.
That might make a difference.
You
know what I think the problem was, Nick?
Huh?
We forgot to use coconut oil.
Oh, coconut oil, the organic stuff.
Well, it doesn't have to necessarily be organic. As long as it says coconut oil, you're good.
Yeah, I should have used coconut oil.
But that's right. We kind of made a mistake there.
gluten-free coconut oil, actually.
They make that?
You just don't want gluten in anything. Yeah, you don't want it in your coconut oil. It's bad stuff.
Okay, there we go.
Okay, all right. That was off the transmission, the hydrostatic drive motor mounts right there, which runs the transmission and the combines, which you can't really see. They're sitting outside those bright windows. The other day, it stripped out while we were running, and so the combine was dead in the water, so we had to pull it back and rip it out. So anyways, back to where I am. Put this back here. Finish this up. So it's gonna fall. Okay, good. Nice. All right. Back to burning the skin. I'd wear gloves, but it's hot and makes your skin tougher. I know. I actually have gloves. There's some right there. Another 1,000 hours or something. Yeah, don't touch that. Yeah. Okay, all right. Well, let's see what we got here. So I'm not putting them back in the original spot because it's obviously cracking there. So they have these holes pre-drilled to change the arrangement of them. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put them in on the side. But since I'm already in the process of welding all these, I might as well just keep going. Let's make a stack. Let's take this spreader off. I'll come back and get that one later. Take this one. Okay, let me put my phone up in my little awesome headset here. I don't know if this is quite as exciting as actually running the machinery or not. Okay. All right. Well, we don't need the welder for a few minutes. I'll turn it off. Now I need my impact gun. Let's see here. Oh, there it is. I need that right there. Okay. There's my set of screws and bolts from when I did the first one. I haven't done these yet. There's one. I'll put one of these back in. Every time, so I'll take these all off. Okay. Take that one out. Take that out, anyways. Nuts all over the place here. Okay. See, there's one. Where's my other one go? Didn't see it fall. It's hiding here somewhere. I got another one. I can steal one from something. I have no idea. When stuff falls, it's amazing how it vanishes. From sight. Okay, where was I? Those are on. Put a bolt back on that one.
This thing's pretty awkward. It's not the easiest thing to maneuver around. Let's put a bolt back in there. Okay. That one, and that's this one. Oh, I saw where that one went. Okay. All right, so we put this aside. We're back to this spot again, welding these back up. Man, this has got to get boring.
This is going to be a lot of this. Oh man, that is quite a hairdo. I don't know if you guys want to watch this whole thing. But anyways, that's what I'm doing. So I probably got another hour working on this. And then I'll go to something else. So it hurts no matter what kind of skin. Yeah, yeah, hot stuff does hurt the skin. You get used to the little sparks, but it at first everyone freaks out when they start welding because they think it's burning everything. But if you get a chunk of molten on you, usually if you don't have a spot where it can rest, like if it lands on your arm and it's not like a crevice or anything, it'll just roll off and doesn't really hurt. But sometimes sparks land in areas like your shoes and things, and that's where it's bad. But no, the sparks aren't as bad actually. It's the molten stuff, the chunks of metal that's red hot and fire, that burns a little bit. But your skin lets you know pretty quick, and usually you flex and pull your arm back and it flies off. So, okay. All right, well, do you guys want me to keep airing this, or you guys want me to stop? Because I can leave this phone on. It doesn't bother me. I'm on Wi-Fi here. Why don't you open that door if it was saying it's hot? Because it's actually hotter outside than it is inside. We have the door shut because it's keeping the cool air inside. Outside's hotter. So we don't have AC in the shop. Do something else when do a live. Keep it going. Nice. Okay. All right. I'll keep it going. You guys can hang out. Weld these up.
ain't pretty. This is powder coated, but if you just force the weld on it, it'll burn through it. Something like this isn't structural, so it doesn't have to be ground down and made clean. Like that rust, normally you would take the rust off metal, any paint, any powder coat, any dirt, to give it a nice clean weld, but that kind of weld is going to hold plenty for what we're cutting, so no problem there. But you can see the old, see where it's all wore off. So, yeah, there, that ought to help fling some straw. Let's bolt these up. I'll do put one of these together, or two of them together, and then we'll put them on the combine. And let me put my headset back on here. Hang on a minute. Okay. All right. So, make some room. Let's cool these off so I don't accidentally burn myself. Okay. Okay, let's take this one back. Now, probably the back side. So I'm just going to put it in the center. They've got three sets of holes here for different mounting options. I'll just go ahead and put it in the center one. Let's put this one in first. Right there. This thing is so awkward. There we go. Okay. Last one. Clumsy fingers, keeps dropping stuff. Here we go. There. Okay. Oops, I got that backwards. Flip that around. There we go. Oh, that's right, that's right. I'm on the wrong hole there. There we go. Come on, thread on right. You talk to yourself a lot while you're working. I found that out the case. At least I do. I don't think it helps anything, but that one's gonna be a pain. I think the threads are. Might have gotten hit at one point in time. There we go, okay. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, I gotta use the screwdriver. Hold the bottom of this. Okay. All right. One more.
find that missing nut, or I'm going to have to go dig in our nut bin and see if I can find one. It's somewhere on this floor underneath this table. Kicked somewhere. All right, one last pass. Let's take a look. Let's see if we can find it. Old glove. Bet it's in here somewhere. No. Okay, let's go find another one. Oh, wait, there she is. Ha-ha. Couldn't hide forever. Ah, that one's going to be a bugger, too. I don't know why some of these. They must have, when we drop this, after we take these spreaders off, sometimes we drop them on the ground, and I think they might hit things, and these threads get banged up a little bit. Okay, so what we've done is moved, rotated them, the spreaders to a new set of holes to get rid of these wear spots where it's causing cracks in this aluminum disc here, and then welded new ends on every one of these, so hopefully it won't wear and it'll keep spreading well. But this one actually hasn't wore through, so I'm not gonna, that is right there. I was gonna plate it. You can see the crack, it's starting to crack through. I was going to put a piece of flat iron across and bolt it on, but that's actually not that bad. I might skip on this one. Let that one go a little longer. So this one's done. Let's do this one. But I think I want to get this one fixed because this one's got a lot worse cracks on it. So my plan, doesn't, probably won't take a lot of very heavy flat piece of flat iron here. Just roughly measure. All these cracks are probably about the same spots, aren't they? Yeah, they are. Okay. What is that? That's let's cut one of these off. Put my eye protection on. This marker's about done. Okay. Nice about doing this kind of repairs, you don't have to worry about being really precise. Of them. That looks pretty good. Perfect. Because I think it'll be the same for all these. I imagine they're all machined the same. Yeah. So let's take these. I made extras because I think some of these panels have cracks in them too. Let's go over to the drill press. Let's see here, what size are we? Find out what diameter here we need to, for a drill bit. These are punches, center punches actually is I think the correct term for them. Really nice. Okay, it's definitely bigger than that. I smaller than that one. Probably this one right here. Nope, not quite. We'll find it. Nope. Maybe I had it the first time I had it in my hand. There it is right there. Okay. That's the diameter we need. And that one is, that center punch is really beat up. Okay, so we'll go back over to the drill presses here. Let's get a hammer. That's a good hammer right there. That's a nice one. Let's do that. Okay, and then what I'll do is so that the drill bit bites in the correct spot, I'll take the center punch. I know that one's kind of wore off. Let me get a better one. Use this little one for now. Put it roughly where I marked earlier. Give it a good whack. That is not much of a dent at all. Okay, anyways. And then, we're missing our drill bits. There they are. Let's find a bit that matches that size. A little bit bigger. I think it looks sharp enough. Okay. So, oops, let me know where my camera's at. All right, there we go. I can't even see what I'm doing here. There it is. Yeah, this drill bit's been cut before. Let's get a different drill bit. Someone's tried to sharpen this one, and the center is off on it. It's flatter and so thin, you can't even see where I'm going with it. Okay. Truck's just about wore out on this one. There we go. Alright, how does that compare to my other dots I made? I didn't even. Can't even see on that one. Must not have marked it. I don't even see any marks that I did on any of these. Did I only do one of them? I guess I did, didn't I? It's just this one. Before I do any more, let's just make sure that lines up correctly here. A little wide. It'll be fine. Okay. Let me get a better marker. That Sharpie that I've got is about... I'm dead. So, let's remark these. We'll make a bunch more. I'm going to deliberately make them a little narrower, though, because I think I got off just a hair. I don't even know if I need to center punch this. It might cut in it just fine. Let's just try drilling it. that's a lot better. Let's do that. I like that one a lot better. So let's mark this one. Use this as our... I can't say I've ever had everyone watch me work before. It does make it a little different. You notice your mistakes a lot more when you got people watching, huh? But that's the fun of it. Okay. Drill these out. Couple more of these to go, and then we'll bolt them on, and then I'll take those spreaders and put them back on the combine. If this little bit of work we're doing here adds more life to these spreaders, it's well worth the time doing this, because those spreaders, I imagine, are not just given away. They probably charge enough for them. So you can lengthen the life of something, why not? It's all gonna end up eventually in the scrap pile someday, so let's delay it as long as we can. And you learn to work fast too. Though working fast doesn't always make for good work. Sometimes it's just a matter of getting it done. All right, there. So we got one extra, but we'll use that as our blueprint for the other ones when we make some more. Okay. Put these all back. I'll leave that drill bit in there. Okay, let's get some bolts here. I got a little bit larger of a drill bit than what was on there. See, yeah, it is that. So it's got to be these right here. Let's just take the bin. I think that is half inch, so we should have the tools over here to tighten these up. All right. Okay. Let's just do the shortest we can find here. We don't need anything real long. That might be too short. Let's try that. Oh, yeah, I can use that. Okay. And I will put lock washers on these because I don't want them flying off. That might be painful if it hits someone. You know what? Let's put this on the bottom side. That's a lot better. Okay. Before I tighten that up, the other one in. And I need a longer bolt. That's not going to fit with that lock washer on there. Okay. And I don't really feel like putting any washers on it either, because I don't think it's necessary. Threads on it. Try this one. A lot of times when we're done working, we'll pick up a lot of random bolts and nuts and put them back in the bins to reuse them, because you hate throwing away stuff, but you never know if they're got dings in the threads or not. Then you find out the hard way that they do.
I gotta get a half an inch wrench. There we go. Like a glove. All right. Okay, let's do it. Next one. And shorter than that. That's a good one right there. And a short one. Yeah. There we go. Perfect. Those will work. Two of these. I don't know if I have the angle of this camera pointed very well. I knew I had to point it down a little bit because typically when you're looking with your head, you're always looking down. So I have this camera pointed down on my phone. Now that one is the one I, well, actually that might work still. Yeah, oh yeah, it'll work. Now if this stops it from chattering and cracking through the rest of this, this is an easy fix. I gotta get a half inch. One second. Okay. Let's see. Let's take. You know what? Let me get one of these. Perfect. One over left over here. And the shorter one, mid-length. You know what? I just don't really care. I'll just put a... I don't think the balance will get thrown off that bad if these aren't the same size. I've already modified this enough to... Okay. Are a lot longer. Oh well. That's okay. Where's that in wrench at? There it is. Hold the top of the bolt. Tighten her up. That one's tight too. Okay. Alright, we're making progress here. Okay, so now we got the cracks fixed for the most part. I really don't know if that's... I probably should have put a whole plate on there, but I think that'll... I think that'll do a lot for strength. Let's put these on. I'll just put them on like this, then I'll flip it over and tighten everything up. Oh, come on. Unless it fights me like it is. There we go. Nice when it's all done. I always feel like
sense of accomplishment when you finish a small project and then you get it running on the machine again and it lasts a while. That doesn't always happen. A lot of times we think we fixed it and only to find out that our hours and time spent doing our repair just ended up for nothing because we had to go buy a new one anyways. But this, it's amazing how you can save money doing this. Okay, I am missing a bolt. Where did I lose a bolt? Let's go dig in the bolt bin, see if we can find. Nothing in here? Nothing like that? Thought for sure I'd find one in there. Okay. Try the other bin. My great-grandpa built this. This bolt and screw holder. Yeah, those are just, that's not going to be in there. Huh, okay. They call these stew bolts, I think, at the time. Stew screws. No. No. Huh, I don't know where I lost it. Oh, here we go. Jackpot. Gotta keep looking. Okay. My plan is to eventually get a camera, a phone with a wide-angle lens on it, because this lens seems to be kind of narrow, and you don't always know where it's looking. But a wide-angle lens, you can capture so much more. Okay. All right. Whoop. Got two of these done. Nice. All right. Well, I got to walk out there and put this on the combine now. 86 people still watching. That's amazing. You guys are great. But I don't know if my Wi-Fi is going to handle it going out there. So. It might get choppy, it might cut out. We'll see what happens. But I'll carry these out here and put them on, and then I'll probably stop the stream for now. So an hour is long enough, huh? All right, let me flip this back. Okay. Take me. There's our one of our buddies. Napping away. Hey, Cobras, what are you doing? Okay. Now, all I do, button. There we go. This one, I think needs a shaft cleaned up. It's kind of nasty. So let's go and get a drill with a brush on it and clean it up. Okay, take a battery. And that'll work perfect right there. Make it slide on and off a little better. You get kind of gummy over time. Okay. Well, we'll see how long they last. Now to do the other one. And there's Hank. I better show Hank real quick. Hi, Hankers. Hey, buddy. Yeah. And Kobe. Good boy, Cobers. All right, let's see here. Okay. I'm sure I probably lost signal there. All right. Let's go in the cool office real quick. Got an air conditioner in here. This is nicer. All right, where's my chat at? I'm back. That was fun, wasn't it? What am I doing? I was repairing the straw spreaders on our combines. They're getting wore out, so I had to rebuild some of them and put them back on. What's going on here? There we go. Okay. Does anyone know how popular crop? What was that? My chat's not there. There it is. Okay. Does anyone know how popular crop dusting is in Montana? Crop dusting is, it happens. It's not as much as it used to be. I got metal filings in my hair. Nice. This summer, a neighbor north of us was doing it. It all depends on conditions. Guys have such big sprayers anymore that we don't... Oh, is my Wi-Fi? It's not bad. We don't really use crop dusters anymore, but when the weather's bad or in a crunch, guys will still hire them. Idaho, nice. Nova Scotia. I wish I could say I know where all these places are. I should know. Yeah. Amazing how many people are. Love your video. Thanks, Mr. Jeff. Appreciate it. What's up, guys from Kansas? Nice. Taking my little break here. You know, I think we're allowed to get a break every now and then, right? And then back at it. So what's else happening? I guess for us, I'm thinking we'll probably start cutting. Probably today, actually. If we get everything going, we might try on some of the spring wheat. We have some we seeded early. That's probably ready. It's only 100 acres, so if we get started on it, we'll knock it out today. No problem. But the rest of it's probably a couple days out, maybe Wednesday. It's turning fast, though, really fast. And we really don't know what... They got hurt pretty hard with the hot weather, so... You added bracing metal to one side, not the other. Is that going to put the balance of running? Well, the spreader I put them on, I put it on evenly in three different places. So the one spreader has it, the other spreader does not, but they're separate of each other, so it shouldn't mess up anything with timing. And they're on a belt system, so there's some give on it too. Wanting to be a pilot someday. You know, you might not think this is crazy, but I'm actually a pilot. I went to school for pilot training. But
I only fly little putt-putts. I don't fly anything real fancy. So, got to work in 8.5 hours. Yeah, you better go to bed. Are you making another speed repair of an old tractor? You know, it all depends if we get a tractor in the shop. Yeah, I think we'll try it. It just depends. That we had two big buds that needed work done to them, so we did it. Our other big bud needs a paint job and some other stuff done. So I might do a video on that. It just won't be as extensive. It won't be like a engine swap or transmission removal or anything like that. It'll be cab fixing, insulation, painting, decals, lights, that kind of stuff. So, but we do have that Versatile that we're looking at maybe putting an engine in as well. So you never know. You never know what happens around these places. We come up with some pretty fun projects right now and then, so. Though it would be nice to have a winter without doing one of those projects, because winters are when farmers are supposed to, you know, relax, have fun. But we have fun in the shop, I guess. So. Well, I suppose, guys, I should probably call it here. Get back to work. And I'm going to do basically the exact same thing you guys just watched. So, do two more of those, get them all done. And then jump to the next project. So, this is fun, isn't it? Okay. You can come help with our IH. Oh, wow, that would be cool. I love tractor pulls. Europe really is on top of that. You guys, the tractor pulls are the best. An air tractor, 502B. Is that a turboprop? I don't know a lot about air tractors, but I do know a lot of them use the Pratt & Whitney PT6. And some of them are like homing engines too, I think. So, did we change the air filter in our combines? No, we go like every other year. We just actually today ordered new air filters, so they'll be in tomorrow. Lost it. Okay, I'm back. Anyways, yeah, we get new air cleaners every other year, but we clean them out ourselves. Montana's about 90 degrees today. So, all right, I better go. Take care, everyone. God bless. We'll catch you later. I'm sure eventually I'll be back on again. So, that was fun. Okay. All right, see ya. Thank you.